Thank you, Ilana, and good afternoon. I'm Dr. Yvette Rubido, and I am from the National Congress of American Indians, or NCAI, which is the oldest, largest, and most representative national organization serving the broad interests of American Indian and Alaska Native tribal nations, and we work to support and defend tribal sovereignty. We are pleased to be a part of this racial equity anchor collaborative. The 2020 census is extremely important because its data can be used for representation at the national, state, and local levels in redistricting efforts to ensure fair representation and resources in federal funding formulas, in research, and it is used by tribal nations in local governance and decision making. So the stakes are high as we look at the data. Today's news is great news. America is more diverse than ever, and that diversity is a strength, not a weakness. We are excited to see that the data confirms that what we already see in our communities, our schools, workplaces, and with friends and families. We look forward to reviewing the diversity data released today in more detail. One initial observation, for NCAI, we are pleased to see the overall growth in the American Alaska Native population and its diversity, but we have to be careful to no longer use just American Indian Alaska Native alone data. We have to acknowledge that the American Alaska Native in combination data also, because it in terms of how the Census Bureau collected and coded the data in 2020. And tribal citizens are included in the American Alaska Native alone data and in the American Alaska Native in combination data. Therefore, federal funding formulas that use just the American Indian Alaska Native alone data are significantly undercounting our population. Well, we know from decades of our work that the vast majority of American families care about opportunities for their children, quality health care, higher wages, common sense immigration reform, and strong neighborhoods. Yes, while these are priorities for our communities of color, we know that working class families of all races and ethnicity across the country share these priorities too. American Indians and Alaska Natives, as with other diverse groups, are a fundamental part of this more diverse nation and contribute to the economy and cultural richness of America. That's why we hope these data can result in more education in schools that is accurate, and that in American history classes, it also includes accurate information about the past and current history of American Indians and Alaska Natives and other diverse groups. Tribal nations make significant contributions to local, state, regional economies and contribute to the rich culture of the United States. We have been concerned about the quality and usability of the data from the 2020 census due to the impact of the COVID-19 pandemic on enumeration efforts and the potential negative impact of the new privacy measures, which likely will cause errors in data for small, rural, and remote populations, which does include many smaller tribal nations. The NCAI Policy Research Center is excited to get our hands on this data and analyze it to see how the counts look for the American Indian Alaska Native population at the various geographic levels and for tribal nations. Here with us today, we also have Gwen Evans Lomayesva, who will be analyzing the data, and she can answer some of the more technical questions that may arise in the Q&A. We will be releasing our analysis and results soon on our website. We are also excited that the official redistricting season begins with the release of this data. Our civic engagement team is a part of the Coalition Hub Advancing Redistricting and Grassroots Engagement, or CHARGE, collaborative, and is holding trainings for tribal nations on how they can participate in the process at state and local levels. They can learn their state's process for redistricting, attend commission meetings or hearings, testify on the importance of fair redistricting, and say how important every voice needs to be heard and the importance of resource allocation that is fair and accurate for all communities, including tribal nations, to get the resources that they need and deserve. We have participated in tribal consultation census sessions with the U.S. Census Bureau that have been in addition to the stakeholder input to try to ensure that this data is accurate and as usable as possible for tribal nations. And while we still have concerns, we will be encouraging more tribal consultation as the U.S. Census Bureau works on the next data product, the demographic and housing file, which will have more detailed data on race, ethnicity, and tribal geographies next year. But now our major focus will be encouraging everybody to participate in redistricting efforts to ensure fair representation, equal opportunity to vote for everyone, and fair allocation of resources. We are also, again, excited to dig into the data released today on the population numbers. The data released today helps us all get started on this important work. Thank you for the opportunity to respond to the exciting results from the 2020 census today, showing the full picture of diversity in America, and to encourage all to participate in their state and local redistricting efforts. Thank you.